Once upon the midnight dreary, while I pondered weak and weary, over many a quaint and curious volume of forgotten lore, while I nodded, nearly napping, suddenly there came a tapping, as of someone gently rapping, rapping at my chamber door. "'Tis some visitor," I muttered, "tapping at my chamber door. Only this, and nothing more." And the silken, sad, uncertain rustling of each purple curtain thrilled me, filled me with fantastic terrors never felt before, so that now, to still the beating of my heart, I stood repeating, "'Tis some visitor entreating entrance at my chamber door, some late visitor entreating entrance at my chamber door. This it is, and nothing more." Presently my soul grew stronger, hesitating then no longer. "Sir," said I, "or madam, truly your forgiveness I implore, but the fact is I was napping, and so gently you came rapping, and so faintly you came tapping, tapping at my chamber door, that I scare was sure I heard you. Here I opened wide the door, darkness there, and nothing more." Into the chamber turning, all my soul within me burning. Soon again I heard a tapping, somewhat louder than before. "Surely," said I, "surely that is something at my window lattice. Let me see then what thereat is, and this mystery explore. Let my heart be still a moment, and this mystery explore. 'Tis the wind, and nothing more." Open here I flung the shutter, when with many a flirt and flutter, in there stepped a stately raven, of the saintly days of yore. Not the least obeisance made he, not an instant stopped or stayed he, but with mien of lord or lady perched above my chamber door, perched upon the bust of Pallas just above my chamber door, perched and sat and nothing more. Then this ebony bird beguiling my sad fancy into smiling, by the grave and stern decorum of the countenance it wore. "Though thy crest be shorn and shaven, thou," I said, "art sure no craven, ghastly, grim, and ancient raven, wandering from the nightly shore. Tell me what thy lordly name is on the night's Plutonian shore." Quoth the raven, "Nevermore." So the raven, sitting lonely on the placid bust, spoke only that one word, as if his soul that one word he did outpour. Nothing further than he uttered, not a feather than he fluttered, till I scarcely more than muttered, "Other friends have flown before. On the morrow he will leave me, as my hopes have flown before." Then the bird said, "Nevermore." By seraphim whose footfalls tinkled on the tufted floor. "Wretch," I cried, "thy God hath lent thee, by these angels he has sent thee, respite, respite and nepenthe from my memories of Lenore. Quaff, oh, quaff this kind nepenthe, and forget this lost Lenore." Quoth the raven, "Nevermore!" prophet, said I, thing of evil. Prophet still is bird or devil. By that heaven that bends above us, by that God we both adore, tell this soul with sorrow laden, if within the distant maiden, it shall clasp a sainted maiden, whom the angels name Lenore. Clasp a rare and radiant maiden, whom the angels name Lenore. Quoth the raven, nevermore. And the raven, never flitting, still is sitting, on the pallid bust of Pallas just above my chamber door. And his eyes have all the seeming of a demon's that is dreaming. And the lamplight over him streaming throws his shadow on the floor. And my soul from out that shadow that lies floating on the floor